Sure you want to continue doing that to my brother?
Ultra Street Fighter 4 is the latest and hopefully the final iteration to the 4-year-old Street Fighter 4 series. Capcom has pulled out every bit of juice in this one to make it shine as a really definite version of the game. Although when this iteration was announced, I was skeptical and not happy with the announcement as it just seemed a huge price DLC or a patch that should have been free in the first place. But after trying out the new version myself, I can say that I was somewhat wrong and the amount of changes that went into the game are quite substantial to justify the existence of Ultra Street Fighter 4. First of all, I will jump to the more of a general review of the Street Fighter 4 rather than going into specific changes for the veterans of the series. When it comes to the story of the game, Street Fighter has been worst of the fighting games lot. Mortal Kombat 9 surprised me of how well a story mode can be added to a fighting game, and Injustice Gods Among Us followed up on with it with an equally strong story mode, which in turn makes Street Fighter 4 feel like a B-grade movie. Story in Ultra Street Fighter 4 doesn't change from Street Fighter 4, with a secret organization holding an elite fighting tournament with a hidden agenda, and different fighters are gathering to prove their worth or find their rivals to take revenge. The story is pretty non-existent in gameplay. Within each character, you will get an enemy-style intro and outro video, which most of the time had nothing to do with the rest of the game. Those who don't like read wikis to read each character's backstory will be left baffled as to what is happening in those scenes, and thus end up being a useless addition to the game. Visually, the game is still same as Street Fighter 4. Maybe they have fixed a few models or revised some rendering methods, but to naked eye, it's hard to differentiate it from the 4-year-old version, which is a good thing as well. To show how good the game style looks even after all these years as compared to say Mortal Kombat 9, which by the time it was released on PC already looked dated with low resolution textures and models. Now, coming to the changes brought in the game for Ultra version, I will go into detail over two categories of target consumer. Number 1, for casual gamer. The common folk would be only interested in the new content in the game. If you already are coming from Super Street Fighter 4 Arcade Edition, then the list is not that big. It adds 5 new characters, which are Hugo, Rolento, Poison, DiCaprio and Elena. It also comes with 6 new stages and plenty of alternate costumes and colors. But I do wish they had added the option to individually customize each item on the character and their colors rather than just preset costumes to make it feel like the true Ultra edition of the game. If you are an owner of Street Fighter Cross Tekken, then this list will appear even smaller as 4 out of these 5 new characters were already available there. Only DiCaprio is the real newcomer, and the shame is that she is visually a clone of Kame, even though she has a different move and skill set which would have been best suited for a new look of a player. Even the stages are taken directly from Street Fighter Cross Tekken, so it appears that Capcom just brought their own non-Tekken cast from Street Fighter Cross Tekken to Super Street Fighter 4 Arcade Edition and released it as Ultra Street Fighter 4, which is pretty shameful move. If you are a casual gamer with Street Fighter Cross Tekken already with you, then Ultra Street Fighter 4 will hold no charm. On other hand, if you are on Super Street Fighter 4 Arcade Edition, then it will appear like a DLC to you, and instead of purchasing the full game, you can buy the USF4 upgrade pack, which appears like a DLC and will update your game to Ultra Street Fighter 4. Number 2, for hardcore gamers. Next, let's review for the hardcore gamer perspective. Capcom has fine-tuned each and every fighter and balanced them. if you just go through the change log, which is difficult to really mention all of it here, then you will be baffled to see the detail they went into making the weak attacks of even the less used characters more usable and balanced so that they get more of a fighting chance. Other than balancing, there are changes to some of the technical fighting mechanics. First of all, the combo meter has been revised to have two parts. Double ultra combo meter can now be used to release both your ultra combos together. Then there is the red focus, which is a defensive move as it absorbs attack to build up the ultra meter at twice the speed. This can be used as a really big punishing move for those hurried attackers who don't go into technical details. Another defensive technique that has been added to balance the game is the delayed standing after getting knocked down. This can be used to mismatch the timings of the player who punish you as soon as you get up. Do note that this is a review of the game and not a tutorial, of course, so intricate details about all of these new technical moves is not our scope right now, and I urge you to go through the game guide for all such details. But the point I want to emphasize is that how well they have added some really useful features for hardcore gamers to utilize against the typical attackers. Outside the fights, there are plenty of new features that gamers will appreciate, like the ability to save playback of offline matches, uploading videos to YouTube, keep online fight request mode active while you are doing training, etc. These are some of the most requested features for hardcore gamers, and finally they have made it into the game. Performance-wise, the game still has some issues to resolve, as even on a beefier PC like mine, which used to run Super Street Fighter 4 Arcade Edition pretty easily, I can see frame skip on Ultra Street Fighter 4. The issues worsen online, which is not a good thing at all. PC gamers would be especially interested to know how the game netcode fares. Since old Street Fighter 4 used games for Windows Live, which is now shut down, and Super Street Fighter 4 Arcade Edition made its jump to Steamworks. There have been mixed opinion about it, as everyone is happy because it steams, but netcode isn't that efficient and more lag and connectivity issues have been experienced by players. Same woes continue in Ultra Street Fighter 4. First of all, it's pretty hard to find a stable player connection to play with. Then the ping meter shown as a Wi-Fi signal is kind of broken, as it may say 4 bars but end connection with the player is not at all satisfactory. And at times those player with 2 bars would prove a better result. I am not sure about the console version, but the PC version online code needs some immediate patches to put it in stable shape. But hopefully both the frame skipping and netcode issues are something which can be fixed via regular patches rather than via need of a Ultra Super Duper Street Fighter 4 edition to be released. Now the verdict. Overall, if you are a casual Street Fighter 4 player, then Ultra Street Fighter 4 will hold pretty less interest due to the lack of any solid new content, with its weak on story arcade mode that has not changed over the years. You can easily skip this game without a thought. On other hand, for Street Fighter 4 hardcore players, this is easily the most recommended version of the game. With its plethora of balances, new techniques for fighting, and value-added features, this version will be most rewarding of all. Secondly, just like Pro Tournament's adoption of Super Street Fighter 4 Arcade Edition phased out the vanilla Street Fighter 4, same thing Ultra Street Fighter 4 will do to Super Street Fighter 4. So if you like to keep up with pro gaming scene, then it will be inevitable to jump to Ultra Street Fighter 4. Even though it may take a few months to iron out its online kinks.
Poison win!